Alright, so I thought I would do a quick redo on this video because I did do a video on this vacuum about a year ago, but since then I've gotten a brush roll finally for this vacuum. So now you guys can hear this vacuum with the brush roll running. This is probably one of the most sought after newer vacuums for collectors, I would say, under the age of 20. Just because of how short-lived they were and how unusual looking they were. This is a Phantom Wildcat. It was made in 2001, and it was the very last new design from Phantom Technologies before they went bankrupt at the end of 2001. And what distinguished this Phantom from earlier model Phantoms is that this one is single cyclonic. So there's only one cyclone, and that means that more dust is going to be passing on to the premolar filter, which in this vacuum is an electrostatic filter. The problem with that is that the electrostatic filter is very porous, so one of the design flaws with this vacuum was not only the fact that it had a very inefficient single cyclone, but that single cyclone passed a lot of fine dust through the electrostatic filter into the motor, and also managed to get past the post-motor filter, so this vacuum indeed filtered very poorly. But regardless, it's a very unique machine in its design. Very few vacuums have the handle shifted off to the right. I think that's rather unusual to see. And this vacuum came in three different colors, blue, green, and red. And I think each color designated which store the vacuum would be sold at. And I think this blue color may have been exclusive to Kmart, but I'm not sure. Red may have been exclusive to Target, and green for Walmart, but then again, I'm not totally sure on that. Another interesting thing about this Phantom, in comparison to older model Phantoms, is that instead of having a wand that detaches handle that attaches from the vacuum and you can use that for your dusting, this hose detaches totally from the wand itself, and the wand itself does not detach. That's something different. My guess is that this is almost identical to the wand design in the Phantom Fury Limited Edition, which was a modern semi-redesign of the original Phantom Fury, and I think they took the handle design and hose design right off the Phantom Fury Limited Edition and slapped it right on here, and it makes it obvious because they forgot to take off the cord clip. And it's unusual that they have the cord clip here, because the actual cord clip for this vacuum is right here. So this vacuum actually has a cord clip in two places. That just goes to show you how very little thought out this vacuum cleaner was. The bristles are very soft, so it's really not that effective at all on carbonating. But regardless, it's still a very quirky machine and does deserve a place in people's collections, just because of this vacuum really was the signal or the representation of how bad things really became for Phantom before they went under. This machine really embellishes that. There's two switches. There's one switch to keep the brush roll off for fours, and then you can also switch it on for carpeting. So, without further ado, I will run it. And surprisingly, it actually does have decent airflow through the hose when it's not clogged. It is very easy to clog this vacuum because of how inefficient the cyclone is and how quickly the filters fill up with fine dust when they're vacuuming. So, this is the Phantom Wildcat. So that is the Phantom Wildcat. And personally, this is my favorite model of Wildcat because blue is my favorite color. So I just thought I would share that. I hope you enjoyed the video.